During the NRM parliamentary caucus meeting at State House Entebbe, we established that President Yoweri Museveni, who doubles as the NRM party chairperson, spent a better part of it responding to concerns of members of parliament who are trapped in debts by condemning ruthless moneylenders that charge exorbitant interests.
And these moneylenders have been giving people loans on high interest rates, and as if the Ministry of Finance has not properly regulated.
Look at the tomato sellers, for example. Tomato sellers who are paying interest per day, per week. It is too much when you move out there. It is too much. And I think through his intelligence. Because this thing is affecting from the local Ugandans to civil servants.
The president directed the Minister of Finance to be given only 2 weeks to come up with regulations on Tier 4 credit facilities, moneylenders, curtailing them from levying heavy interest rates that are unsustainable. According to the government chief whip, Dennis Hamson Oboa, who addressed the press at Parliament after the caucus meeting, this will be done by operationalizing Section 90 of Tier 4 Microfinance and Moneylenders Act.
So we would want that particular provision envisaged under Section 90 to be operationalized such that we have regulations that will outlaw, even in the worst case scenario, criminalize charging outside the prescribed interest rate in the law.
This year alone, over five legislators have been dragged to civil imprisonment over failure to meet their debt obligations given heavy interest rates charged by the loan sharks. MPs explained that the meeting was not happy with the Minister of Finance sleeping on the job since 2016 when the law was passed to control interest rates charged by moneylenders and failed to activate it, and the minister apologized during the meeting.
The law puts it on the Minister of Finance to come up with a statutory instrument to cap interest rates in the country, especially when we talk about the Tier 4 microfinance law.
The moneylenders charge a lot from what is supposed to be charged. The interest rates are so abnormal. You can imagine charging 4% per month. When you translate that one to a period of 12 months, it is like you are paying 48% per annum.
The president has once again vowed to crush corrupt public servants by introducing reforms in the anti-corruption legal regime to bite harder. He has asked parliament to support him in the cause.
And in his own words, he vowed to crush the corrupt, in his own words. What he is calling for is evidence. As long as there is evidence, you are able to prosecute that particular person in line with the laws of Uganda.
The controversial bloated delegation which Uganda took to the recently concluded UN General Assembly was also a center of focus in today's meeting, as the president put the Vice President Jessica Alupo and the Prime Minister Robina Nabanja on the spot to explain.
So what we are seeing being reported by you members of the media, a delegation of 71, is total misrepresentation of the fact as they are. Their ministers, you indicated, traveled, but they did not. It's total misrepresentation. So that is on the UN.
According to Oboa, the two clarified that reports mistook Uganda's permanent officials at UN as part of the delegation, yet each of the two principals went with only five members in their delegations. According to Oboa, the two clarified that reports mistook Uganda's permanent officials at the UN as part of the delegation, yet each of the two principals went with only five members in their delegations.
But official designated delegation, five. But at their level, they're allowed to travel with security. So be it five, be it seven, but what was reported today is five.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.